All right, good morning. Today we are beginning chapter 2 in our text. Chapter 2 is entitled Graphs, Equations of Lines, and Functions. Let me write that down. Chapter 2 is entitled Graphs, Equations of Lines. EQNS, you'll see, is my abbreviation, usual abbreviation for equations. Equations of lines and functions, all of which you should have some experience with in your first algebra course. And section 2.2 we're going to talk about today is graphing linear equations. All right, let's jump right to it. I'm going to ask you to graph in the xy plane, and I assume that you've all had experience with graphing lines in the xy plane, again, in your first algebra course. So let's jump right to it and graph this equation, y equals minus 1/2 x plus 3. Well, what we're going to do, at least in the beginning of chapter 2, to construct lines of this type, we're going to make a table of values and basically through a guess and check procedure establish pairwise solutions to this equation. So let me put this down. We're going to look for pairwise solutions to this equation. Look for paired solutions to this equation. So in other words, find corresponding x and y values, when substituted, will result in a true statement in this line equation. All right, I'm going to pick x equals 0. Notice y is solved for in this equation. That may make it a little easier to spot solutions. If y is solved for, well, I can pick an x and solve for the corresponding y. I'm going to try to use a little finesse and keep away from fractional coordinates. It's very hard to graph fractional coordinates, as you might understand. And if x is 0, well, we'll see that y equals minus 1/2 times 0 plus 3. And of course, y then equals 3, because 0 times anything equals 0, right? So, all right, so we establish one pairwise solution to this equation, and let's try to find a couple more. It takes 2 points to determine a line, so you could argue that 2 points are enough, but we usually go for at least 3 in case a mistake is made to confirm the solutions to this line equation. All right, I'm going to pick multiples of 2 here. Notice I've got a multiplier of minus 1/2 on x, so if I pick my x values with little finesse, I may not have to deal with some fractional values here. So if x is 2, then y equals minus 1/2 times 2 plus 3. 2 times minus 1/2 is, of course, negative 1, and negative 1 plus 3 is, of course, 2. So I get another paired solution to this equation, and I can keep going here. X is 4. If x is 4, 4 times minus 1/2 is going to be negative 2, and negative 2 plus 3 is, of course, 1. If x is 6, well, 6 times minus 1/2 is negative 3, and negative 3 plus 3 is 0. All right, so I've got plenty of paired solutions to this line equation. I want to highlight a couple of things before we go on. I'm going to highlight these 2 points. Notice in the first paired solution to this equation, when x is 0, y is 3. We call this the y-intercept. Hopefully you're familiar with that term. If x is 0, that means you're on the y-axis somewhere. All right, this is where the line is going to intersect the y-axis. Similarly, I call this point the x-intercept. If y is 0, that means you're on the x-axis somewhere. In other words, you're intersecting the x-axis at that point. Let me do my best to plot these points in the xy plane. I do the best I can by hand. It's kind of impossible to use a straight edge on the tablet here, so I'll have to do my best freehand. If x is 0, y is 3. All right, so if x is 0, y is 3. I'll plot that point right there. And that, of course, is my y-intercept. Notice you're going to intersect the y-axis at that point. If x is 2, y is 2. If x is 4, y is 1. And if x is 6, y is 0. That means you're on the x-axis. All right, if I connect the dots, I see that the solutions of this line seem to form a line in the xy plane, of course, or the solutions to this equation form a line in the xy plane. All right, so of course I need to label the line with the equation that generates it. Y equals minus 1/2 x plus 3, labeling the line. All right, so at least in the beginning of chapter 2, that's how we're going to graph lines, basically create a table of values and use a trial and error type method to generate a table of values and then plot the points, the resulting points, in the xy plane. Let's try another one. All right, I'm going to graph this equation here, 2x minus 5y equals 10. All right, this situation's a little harder because your y variable is not solved for in this two-variable equation. All right, so what I'm going to do, create a table of values, and through a trial and error process, generate a table of values with at least three values. And 2 points determine a line, but again, we like to get a third confirming point just in case a mistake was made in either of the other 2 points. If all 3 points seem to be collinear, fall on the same line, then we can rest assured that we've made no mistakes. All right. Well, this may be a little harder, but luckily 10 is a multiple of 5 and 2. What I'm going to do is let y be 0 here. If y is 0, I'm going to be looking for the x-intercept. What I can do is rewrite my equation with the substituted y value of 0. Well, 5 times 0 is, of course, 0. 2x minus 0 is, of course, 2x. So if 2x equals then 10, x must be 5. Right, so we've right away spotted the x-intercept of this equation. Similarly, I can find the y-intercept, letting x be 0 and solving for y. So, I don't know if we need to be so formal here. Probably get this one by inspection. If x is 0, 2 times 0 is 0. 0 minus 5y is minus 5y. And if minus 5y equals 10, that means y equals negative 2. All right, so we've established the y-intercept. Let's go for another third confirming point, and I think I see one here. If x is minus 5, for example, well, I can plug in minus 5 to this equation and solve for y. So I get minus 10 minus 5y equals 10. And that results in minus 5y equals positive 20. And of course, y then equals minus 4. All right, so I'm going to stop here with our table of values. We could go on forever. There's infinitely many points in a line, as we know. So there are infinitely many solutions. The idea here is you graph 3 or 4 points, and that should establish the pattern. All right, if x is 5, y is 0. You're on the x-axis. This is the x-intercept, 5, 0. If x is 0, y is minus 2. This is the y-intercept. X is 0 when y is minus 2. And if x is minus 5, y is minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm doing my best to draw the scale here freehand. And it looks reasonable to claim that these are collinear points. So I'm going to connect the dots in the xy plane. Notice I'm going to label the axes. I'm going to label the x and y intercepts. I'm going to, most importantly, label the line with the equation that generates it. And I've got a perfect graph. Okay? All right, so we've done a couple examples, hopefully review, of how to graph line equations in the xy plane, at least from first principles. Now I want to go on to horizontal and vertical lines. All right, horizontal and vertical lines. Let's say I ask you to graph the equation y equals 3. Well, the first thing you'll notice in this equation is that x doesn't even appear in the equation statement. Well, that implies something. That implies it really doesn't matter what x is. Y is always going to be 3. Agree? All right, this is really the set of all points in the xy plane that have a y coordinate of 3. In other words, y is constant. Y never changes. Y is a constant positive 3. Well, that means the y-intercept is going to be 3. And I can plot a few points. All of those points have a different x value, but the y-coordinate is 3. I think you can see this is going to result in a horizontal line in the xy plane. And in particular, it's the horizontal line with the y-intercept 0, 3. Let me label that y-intercept 0, 3. There it is. Let me make that dot a little bigger. All right, so I'll label the axes, x and y axes, label the y-intercept, and label the line with the equation that generates it. All right, nothing sacred about y equals 3 here. I think you can agree I could have played this game with any constant value. If y equals constant, you're going to get a horizontal line when you graph that equation with a y-intercept 0, constant, whatever that constant is. Here it was 3. Okay? All right, let's go on to vertical lines. I think the idea is somewhat similar. Vertical lines. Well, if y equals constant gets you a horizontal line, you might think x equals constant gets you a vertical line, and you're right. If I ask you to graph this line equation, x equals minus 2, again, y doesn't even appear in the line equation. Y can be anything, and x is always going to be a constant negative 2. So the graph of this line in the xy plane is really the set of all points in the xy plane that have an x coordinate of minus 2. All right, so let me label the axes right out. All right, well, let me look for the x-intercept first. X equals minus 2 is going to be where this line intersects the x-axis, and all these points that I'm graphing have an x-coordinate of minus 2. So x never changes in this line. X is constant. So the result will be a vertical line in the xy plane with an x-intercept of minus 2. So I will label the line with the equation that generates it. I'm going to label the x-intercept. Well, if x is minus 2, then y is 0. That's my x-intercept. And I've already labeled the coordinate axes. All right, so I'm done graphing this line. And again, nothing sacred about minus 2 here. If you graph the line of the form x equals a constant, and it really doesn't matter what that constant is, you're going to get a vertical line. With the x-intercept coordinate would be, you know, that constant value, whatever it is, and the y-coordinate of 0. All right, so y equals constant, horizontal line, x equals constant, vertical line, right? All right, let's graph a couple more lines for some practice. Some are harder than others. Graph y equals minus 1/3 x minus 1. Let me change that x. Slipped a little bit. Y equals minus 1/3 times x minus 1. All right, now it's possible to do this mechanically and make it a little more cumbersome than it has to be. My idea here is to use a little finesse. Y is already solved for. Y is solved for in terms of x. So what I'm going to do is then pick x values and then solve for y. But I notice I've got a multiplier on x of minus 1/3. That means if I pick x values that are multiples of 3, I will not have to deal with cumbersome fractions. And sometimes we have to deal with fractions, but I like to try to avoid them in graphing. Sometimes you're stuck and you got to deal with them, so rest assured of that. My favorite multiple of 3 is 0. 0 times anything is 0. So if x is 0, I can solve for y pretty easily. Minus 1/3 times 0 is 0, and 0 minus 1 is minus 1. So right away I know the y-intercept is going to be 0 minus 1. All right, let me pick another multiple of 3. Well, 3 is a multiple of 3. And if x is 3, I'll sub that into the equation and solve for y. 3 times minus 1/3 is negative 1. The 3's cross cancel, right? And minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. Oops. So when x is 3, y is minus 2. And I'm going to pick minus 3 as another multiple of 3. And if I sub in y equals minus 3, let me erase this up here. If y equals minus 3, I'm sorry, x equals minus 3, I can easily solve for y. Minus 1/3 times minus 3, well, that's going to be a positive 1. And positive 1 minus 1 is, of course, 0. So I've located the x-intercept here. So I can plot the x-intercept and the y-intercept and a third confirming point. I should be ready to go. Oh, by the way, you will need the graph paper to complete the homework of this section and, of course, the online exam coming up. Please buy graph paper at your local department store. It's probably something in the order of $2 for a pack of 50 sheets, something along those lines. All right, let me go ahead and plot these points. When x is minus 3, y is 0, and I'm doing my best freehand. If x is 0, y is minus 1. And if x is 3, y is minus 2. And it looks to me that these are collinear points. So I'm going to go ahead and connect the dots. Claim that this is my line in the xy plane. Label the axes. I'm going to go ahead and label the x-intercept and the y-intercept. X-intercept is minus 3, 0. The y-intercept is 0, comma, minus 1. And I label the line with the equation that generates it. And we're done. All right, I want to do two more examples, and they're a little tougher, of graphing line equations. Let me get another layer here. Graph 5x minus 4y equals 13. All right, this one's going to be a little tougher. 13 is not a multiple of 5, and it's not a multiple of 4 either. And you know, I suppose I could algebraically solve for y, but if I do that, I'm going to have very cumbersome fractions to deal with, and I would like to stay away from fractions if possible. You know, sometimes you have to. But I think I see something here. If x is 5, well, 5 times x would be 25, and 25 minus 12 is going to be 13, and that's what I'm looking for here, and 4 times 3 is going to give me 12. So when x is 5, y is 3 in this equation. You can check 5 times 5 minus 4 times 3 equals 13. That is a true statement. 25 minus 12 is 13. So I can easily establish a first point on this line. And now comes the hard part. I got to find at least two other points. Let's see. I think if x is 1, 1 times 5 is going to be 5. And if y is minus 2, minus 2 times minus 4 is positive 8, and 5 plus 8 is 13. Let me write that down. 5 times 1 minus 4 times minus 2 is indeed 13. So I've established a second paired solution for this line equation. And I think I see another one. If x is minus 3, minus 3 times 5 gives me minus 15. And if y is negative 7, negative 7 times negative 4 gives me a positive 28. And 28 minus 15 is indeed 13. That one was a little hard to spot. Let me write this down. 5 times minus 3 minus 4 times minus 7. Now let's check it. I get minus 15 plus 28. That's indeed equal to 13. Okay, so it checks out. So if x is minus 3, y would be minus 7. So a little tougher to find three points in equations of this type. But certainly it's doable, and we did stay away from unpleasant fractional values to graph. So let me graph these three points. If x is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and y is 3, 1, 2, 3. Let's be there. Oops, sorry. Not there. And let me fix this. If x is 5 and y is 3, it puts me not on the y-axis, but somewhere over here. Okay, x is 5, y is 3. If x is 1, y is minus 2. Check it, x is 1, y is minus 2. Puts me down here, in the fourth quadrant. And if x is minus 3, 1, 2, 3. Y is minus 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Let me say 7's right here and over there in the third quadrant. All right. Looks to me that these points are collinear. So I'll go ahead and graph them by connecting the points. Of course, we'll do a better job with graph paper. I've labeled the axes. The x and y intercepts are not on this graph right now, and it turns out they're fractional. So I bypassed graphing them and computing them in the xy table of values. So I'm going to go ahead and graph this without the x and y intercepts. All right, the table of values is clearly stated. So I'm going to go ahead and just label this line with the equation that generates it and call it done. All right, one more. We'll call it a day for this section. Graph 3x minus 4y equals 11. Again, y is not solved for in this line equation, and 11 is not a multiple of 4, nor is it a multiple of 3. So it may be slightly more difficult. It's a more difficult caliber problem. Let's see. I've got to find simultaneous x and y values that solve this equation. And I'm thinking 8 plus 3 is 11, right? So if y is minus 2, well, minus 2 times minus 4 is positive 8, and x can be 1, right? Let me sub those values in a little more formally. Everybody see how I did that? I said that if I could get this to be this term to result in a positive 8, well, then easily 3 times 1 is 3, and 8 plus 3 is 11. So if I check this easily, 3 times 1 is 3, minus 4 times minus 2 is positive 8, and 3 plus 8 is indeed 11. So I've established a paired solution for this line equation. X is 1, y is minus 2. All right, let's try another one here. 15 minus 4 is 11, right? So if I can get this turn to be a 15, and then y would be a 1, it would result in a sum of 11. So let me try that. If x is 5, and y is positive 1. Be careful of the signs here. Let's see if this works. 3 times 5 minus 4 times 1. 15 minus 4 is indeed 11, so that checks. And I think I see another one. If x is minus 3 and y is minus 5. Let me try that. 3 times minus 3 is negative 9. And minus 4 times minus 5 is positive 20. All right, so I'll get a minus 9 plus 20 indeed equals 11. Oops, it's an 11 there, right? All right, so I've got 3 points established on the line. Here we go. Coordinate axes. I'm going to plot 3 points on the line. X is 1. When y is minus 2. Puts me here. X is 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. When y is positive 1. And when x is minus 3. 2, 3. Y is minus 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Puts me here. And indeed, these points look collinear. So I claim no mistake has been made. my third confirming point. All right, so connect the dots, and I've got the line equation 3x minus 4y equals 11. Label the line with the equation that generates it. And again, I did not use the x or y intercepts to graph this line, so I don't have to label them. All right, so these last two problems pretty much represent the upper limit of difficulty in the section. So we've hit the 30-minute point. We'll call it a day. This concludes section 2.2, graphing linear equations.